good morning, good afternoon, good evening to all our member friends present here today. I am Natalia Mistry, Chief Marketing Officer of Della Resorts. Today is the launch of a very special committee, the DLT Global Hospitality and Travel Committee. I would now like to introduce to you the maverick behind this magic and madness, an inspiration to us all, the man responsible behind this incredible platform, the founder of DLC, none other than Jimmy Mistry.
Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon to all of you. It's been an amazing journey. Thank you, Natalia. It's been an amazing journey, last 14 months, from where we began to where we are today. A lot has changed, and yet something has remained constant. Our quest and endeavor to set up a platform that connects all the entrepreneurs across the world. Entrepreneurs, professionals, and young leaders, all of them across the world, needed a support system. And that was a quest with which we began to create something like this. DLC has today 2,200 plus honorary committee members across 26 verticals. So without much ado, I would like to begin this evening. The purpose of this evening has been simple: to introduce all you amazing men and women of eminence across to each other, committee by committee, city by city, chapter by chapter. Let me begin this evening by introducing someone very special, someone very respected, and someone we look up to, Chef Alan Coxon. Our first guest of honor from DLC London chapter, Chef Alan Coxon, President of the Chef Jury, International Taste Institute, Ambassador of Taste for Global Gastronomy, British Ambassador for Food and Drink, Patron for Charity UNICEF, awarded with lifetime contribution to the hospitality industry, and 6 gold international awards for innovation and product development. Honorary member of the World Master Chefs and author of 2 award-winning books. Welcome, Chef. A very, very warm, heartfelt welcome from all of us at DLC headquarters in Mumbai, our studios.
Thank you very, very much, Jimmy. It's a wonderful pleasure to have this privilege and honor to be with you this morning, this afternoon, or this evening, wherever you may be in the world, and to share this moment with you and to share the future that you are helping to generate and to change the world. And for me, I know that I'm in one of the finest, one of the best industries in the world, the hospitality sector. It can bring so much joy to not only the people that work in it, but for everyone that visits our hotels, our restaurants, or who we feed. And so I know we've got a huge importance to play. And as we also all know, we have been hit, possibly one of the hardest industries hit, the hospitality and travel sectors, by this incredibly sad pandemic around the world. It has caused huge, significant change in how we've operated and how we are currently working and how we're trying to strive and move forward from the pandemic. It has left us with major challenges. We now need to look at how we work or how we've worked in the past, but to reevaluate ourselves, seriously reevaluate ourselves, bring this magnificent team of people that you are bringing together, Jimmy, to sit down and to work out what is the best way we can actually change our industry, our hospitality sector and travel industry for the better, for the benefit of our future generations that we do so much want into our industry, to learn the skills, to deliver magic for years and years to come. We do not want, we cannot lose the skills of our past years. We cannot. We need to embrace them, but motivate young people to enter our industry. And this platform, DLC, and yourself, Jimmy, bringing people together in such a way, I think it's a wonderful start and a wonderful positive way forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Chef. I resonate your ideas. I firmly believe, being in hospitality business ourselves, there are a lot of operational inefficiencies, and if we can only disrupt this industry by removing the operational inefficiencies and make a more better efficient environment. So without much ado, would request you to launch our global committee AV. I really, really thank you for taking time off and being with us.
We have yet another great chef from London, Chef Cyrus Thoriwala, a friend from our London chapter. Chef Cyrus Thoriwala, British television celebrity chef and restaurateur, cooks, teaches, writes, runs successful restaurants and does more than this fair bit for charity and community. Author of 6 books, appears regularly at the top food festivals around the world, honorary professor of the University of West London, awarded an MBE for services to the restaurant and catering industry. Chef, a very, very warm welcome and a good afternoon from all of us over here.
Thank you very much, actually. I'm already very impressed and absolutely taken aback by all the presentations and everything here. Chef Alan Coxon, of course, stands out. Today, the world has changed in its thinking, particularly our sector. Our sector was built up of very selfish motives from large organizations, focusing on themselves, their training, their development, their processes, and what their bottom line meant. Today, the pandemic is making us all look at different ways of working together and bringing people together. And I think DLC is going to be the perfect platform for people to exchange ideas, for people to exchange problems. I think more importantly, there will be within this mass of expertise, people who can solve problems for others at no cost to them and be able to interact with each other and learn from those mistakes or develop, build and go ahead. So I'm grateful that I'm on this panel and this committee. And hopefully I will be able to share some of my experiences, though they may not be massive, but also to learn from others and see where we can grow, develop, and nurture above all else the future of tomorrow. That is most important to our industry globally.
Thank you, Chef. It's wonderful speaking to you, wonderful hearing from all of you. Our next guest is again from DLC London chapter, Mr. Ricardo Arujo, founder and CEO of Aerodante. Founder and CEO of Aerodante Travel, that crafts some of the most exclusive, luxurious, money cannot buy travel experiences and tours in the world. Ricardo, welcome from all of us.
Hi to everyone on the call. Apparently we are a lot because we are specialized in creating dreams. So basically, if you've ever dreamed to do something crazy, we are, say, the agency to do that. We start with what's impossible, from spending the night on top of the Arc de Triomphe in a suite made of glass, to visit a nuclear submarine, or even go to space, to the International Space Station. That's the kind of things we do. So the way we work, it's by understanding each person's passions and interests, and then creating something completely bespoke, a one-off experience, one-off trip, to take them basically anywhere. So the only limitation, let's say, is imagination.
Ricardo, it's amazing what you do. I have gone through some of it and this is exactly what we resonate. Thank you, Ricardo.
Thank you to you. Lovely meeting you all and enjoy the event.
Thank you. I have another pleasure to invite Anurag Bhatnagar on stage. Anurag Bhatnagar, COO, the Leela Palaces, Hotels and Resorts, awarded the most outstanding care for the community Hotelier of the Year by Hotelier India, Young Achiever in Hospitality Industry, ITB Berlin, Legacy Starwood Security Champion for South Asia and a member of Overseas Security Advisory Council, Young Achiever in Hospitality, Best General Manager by American Academy of Hospitality Sciences. I can go on and on, Rob. Welcome in our studio.
I think it's a fantastic platform that you've created, Jimmy, and congratulations. Just heard
you.
That you've been acknowledged as the world's best kind of platform, which is
the world's first business platform.
Fantastic. So great achievement, and I can see why, and really looking forward to be a part of this group. And as you said, success, from moving from success and transitioning into sharing. So I really believe that there's a lot that reimagination, resetting that can be done now. It has brought in some lots of learnings, and I'm hopeful and confident that many of them will be permanent for us. The reset that you spoke about earlier is going to be like moment of truth and moment of reckoning, has really brought us to where we want the industry to be, and what, as you mentioned, about some of the inefficiencies that we probably, or let's call it the luxuries that we were used to earlier, probably may be different. How we see the world is different. And also, I just like to add one point. Consumer behavior has changed.
Yeah.
Customers have changed, and we have to be ready for the new curve, and ready and willing. But all that in a later time. Really excited to be a part of this forum and this platform, and thank you for having me here.
Thank you, and a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you so much. Looking great forward. To be here.
I would like to invite Pearl Sangha on stage.
I'd also like to introduce our next guest, Harpal Singh Sokhi, director Tarbun Tarka Hospitality Private Limited, awarded the most popular food show, hosted by Food Food Channel, Best Chef of the Year by Indian Restaurants Award of Honor by Chefs Association of Five Rivers, India-Australia Friendship by the Australian Indian Innovations Inc. and Most Admired Celebrity Chef of the Year by 94.3 MyFM. Chef, welcome.
Thank you so much, Jimmy, and thank you so much to the entire August forum that I see a lot of people here. It's a real pleasure to be amongst all of you. I'm happy that there are forums like this at the global level that are being created, and I'm sure we all need international forums that will help us connect globally. So I'm very happy to be here amongst all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Chef. Thank you, Paul. I have another guy who's handling the hospitality committee, Nadeem.
Hi, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I would like to now introduce to our next guest of honor, Ms. Amrutha Nair, Director of Arya Hotels. She's part of Hoteliers of India's power list, awarded for the Generation Next Hospitality by All India Association of Industries. Young entrepreneurs of the society, young FICCI ladies, organization, women achievers, and rising star of Hotel at Investment Forum. Welcome, Amrutha Nair.
Thank you for having me. And thank you for the invitation to join the DLC Hospitality and Travel Committee. The past 18 months has taught us the importance of communication, cooperation, and giving back. And this also happens to be the basic premise behind forums. The whole idea is to not just give advice, but learn from sharing experiences. And I think that's a great way of approaching problems that we have, and like you said, tackling the top 5%. And so I'm delighted to be here, and I look forward to interacting with the fellow DLC hospitality members so that we can all come together and rise together.
Thank you. I have another request of you. We've created a LinkedIn community page for DLC. I would love it for you to launch it.
It would be my pleasure, Dinesh. Thank you.
Thank you, Amrutha. Thank you, Nadeem. I have yet another friend to invite who's present with us today, a stalwart in the hospitality industry, Gurbaksh Singh Kohli, Joint Managing Director of Pritham Group of Hotels, current President of HRAWI, member of the Executive Committee of the Hotel and Restaurant Associations for the last 15 years, acting President in charge of FHRAI, which is the National Apex Body of Hospitality. Welcome, buddy. Good to have you with us.
Thank you, Jimmy. The least I can say is very, very impressive. Of course, I've been in the know of the formation of DLC. I have been in the know of DLC and its formation and
right from the beginning.
And how hard you've been working. So impressive is the least I can say. It's also it's wonderful to be a part of such an august committee, especially when it's very, very impressive when we find that DLC is one of the first platforms to be globally accepted in 300 publications, you said, including Forbes. So congratulations for that. I'm looking forward to work along and be a part of this and contribute in any small way that I can.
Thank you. I'm sure you can contribute in a lot of ways with the amount of experience. You're a stalwart in the trade. I'm quite aware of that.
Thank you for being here and supporting us. I have yet another young lady to introduce on stage, Pearl Mystery.
A warm welcome to our honorary committee members from the Global Experiential Travel and Hospitality Committee. It's an absolute pleasure to be here with you today. While we're here today, there's somebody I would like to introduce from the DLC Global Chapter, from Switzerland, Chris Franzen, MD Oris Advisors, awarded Business Excellence, nominated for the J.A. Pritzker Award for Leadership and the Donald N. Pritzker Award for Hotel Team of the Year. Welcome, Chris.
Good evening, good afternoon. I tried to unmute myself, but it didn't work. I'm blown away. What a great committee, and I mean, the caliber of people on this DELA Leaders Board is unbelievable. Our industry needs a lot of reinvigoration, a lot of people with leadership qualities who just can show the young guys that there is a future, that they can fulfill their dreams. Ricardo talked about creating dreams for travelers. I think it's our responsibility to create dreams for our associates as well. Interactions need to be full of passion and interest and not just trained behavior. And I'm looking forward to be part of this and help and assist whatever I can. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Cliff. Thank you, Paul. Have the pleasure to invite another director on stage, Shilpi Singh.
I would like to introduce Mr. Hans Legowich. He's from London chapter, known for his global mindset, having worked and lived in 6 countries and managed various travel companies around the world. Hans is president of the international businesses of Albatross Travel, including Albatross Expeditions, Albatross Arctic Circle, Albatross Africa, and Adventure Marathons, also a trustee of the Safer Tourism Foundation. And we are delighted to know that how your organization is supporting the climate. So basically, the ships that they have, it promises the lowest emission. They have the cleanest engines and the lowest emission of the greenhouse gases, right?
Thank you for being here. It's a really exciting gathering all together from all over the world. The hospitality is fun, hospitality is passion, and hospitality is global because it's all about traveling and crossing borders and meeting new people and meeting new cultures. So very excited to be here. Let's exchange more. Let's have more cultural understanding and exchanges, learn from each other, and also explore the world together with each other. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hans.
Thank you so much.
Shilpi, thank you.
Thank you.
We have our Dubai chapter director. Welcome, Martha.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to introduce our next guest from the DLC Dubai chapter, Chef Nigel Lobo. Group Executive Chef, Stars and Bars. Former executive chef and group culinary administrator at the Royal Orchid Hospitality Group in Dubai. Awarded the Caterer ME Power 50 and highly commended Head Chef of the Year by Stand Alone Restaurant. Welcome, Nigel.
Thank you for the wonderful introduction. It is great to be amongst all of you, pioneers of the hotel industry. And also to be a part of DLC. I would like to congratulate all the members and the team over there. I hope I can share even or make a difference to even one person's life through this platform and take it from there and make the world smaller.
Thank you, Nigel. Lovely speaking with you and looking forward to your contribution and exciting times ahead. Have another friend across within us, a young talented chef, Toshin Shetty. Toshin is an alumnus of the University of Huddersfield, studied culinary arts at Institute of Hotel Management, Aurangabad. Promising young chocolatier, chef, known for his timeless confections like macarons, cookies, handcrafted pralines. So it's amazing to have you. And when people like you share your experiences and knowledge and how your journey has been, I think that becomes an inspiration for the rest of the young leaders to follow.
Yes, as a journey, it's been like born in hospitality, third generation. You are the first generation of entrepreneur, you've set up this. I've seen my father struggle because he was the last guy coming into the hospitality in the family. He strived, yes, this kind of a setup, the platform that DLC is offering, bringing the bridges together, connecting different entrepreneurs from around the world.
Opening up collaborations,
learning experiences.
Yep.
It's going to bring a parity between our country and the entrepreneurs totally. From international entrepreneurs and chefs, and the culinary skills are going to uplift in our country also. Learning from people abroad and learning from industrial leaders and chefs in our country.
Understanding industrial best practices within the trade, and that's something that this platform can do so fantastically, thereby motivating you to follow those guidelines. So it's amazing, and good luck to you. It's a pleasure to have you with us, and thank you for your support. Thank you. Have another friend to introduce, Varun Saraf, an ardent hardcore hospitality project management expert. Varun is also my forum mate. Varun Saraf, managing director, Chartered Hotels, MD of Nepal's leading developers in hydropower space, manages 3 hotels in India, including the Hyatt, board member of International Foundation for Population and Development. Varun, buddy, a warm welcome from all of us.
Thanks, Jimmy. So, would like to congratulate you and the DLC team on this incredible achievement. Over the last few years, I've personally seen you create this platform from just an idea to actually implementing it and the scale that you've already taken it to. And that through the COVID time. So it's quite a remarkable achievement, and I'd like to congratulate all of you. Furthermore, I think this was the best time for you to put this platform together. Our industry has gone through a pretty rough patch, and we've got a shock treatment from this. And now, after all of this, to come together on a platform like this and ideate and collaborate, I don't think it could be a better time for us all to come together and chart the way forward and innovate in our space. So thank you for having me on board, and wishing you all the best.
Thank you, Varun. Well, would like to invite Dr. Vikram Kamath, yet another hospitality legend in India. Dr. Vikram Kamath, founder, chairman, the WITS Kamath Group, recognized as the author, entrepreneur, and founder of WITS Group, All India International Council's gold medalist and topper in hospitality, hotel administration from IHM, Mumbai. Vikram, a very warm welcome from all of us. It's great to have you in our studios with us.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
I think it's a fantastic platform, and the vision. Of course, whenever it comes to Jimmy Mistry, everything has to be done sincerely, superbly, and with style. So I think DLC will continue that rich legacy which Jimmy and Della always has carried through in whatever business you've done. So I think knowledge is the new oil, and content creation is the core focus of DLC, and I think that will be done exceedingly well.
Thank you. It's lovely to have you. You have the honor and pleasure to introduce our next guest.
I take the pleasure of introducing Ms. Asma Khan. The founder of Darjeeling.
Thank you very much. We can learn from each other. I don't think there's a huge difference between, you know, running a restaurant in Calcutta and running a restaurant in London. So I think that, you know, it's very helpful, and I'm looking forward to learning a lot from being part of this chapter. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Asma. Looking forward to meeting up with all of you soon in London with our physical chapter city established and our offices established there. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jimmy. I'm sure we're overwhelmed with success like everything else.
Pleasure. Yet another hospitality legend in the software field in India, Jimmy Shaw. He's a hotelier of Waterfront Shaw, awarded the RCI Platinum Best Timeshare Resort West Ghats, the Waterfront Shaw. Welcome, Jimmy. Lovely to have you with us. And whilst you were just being mic'd up, I shared with all of them that this is the man who triggered the idea of setting up DLC in some way or the other.
Well, thank you very much, Jimmy, for having me here. Because whatever Jimmy does, he always supersizes it. So with DLC, it can go nowhere but extremely big. And I think you are obviously going to do it right. Thank you, Jimmy.
Thank you. Thank you for all the love and support. I would invite Farhan Mistry on stage.
Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon, everyone. It's an absolute pleasure being here with our global hospitality and travel committee. Love to show the entire team, the entire committee rather, the effort it goes into hosting just one such event. If the team could queue in the PCR, that would be great. So it's a team of about 25 to 30 people who go into hosting just one such event. Over there, we have our Zoom coordination team, our back office edit studios, a team of about 70 editors in-house. Coming into the PCR, coming into our pinners, sound, servers, backup servers. We've gone all out to host such fantastic events.
Thank you. Thank you, Farhan. Mr. Chetan Arora, a master franchisee for Subway brand with more than 250 stores. Chetan sits on the National Advertising Board for Subway. Chetan, a warm welcome from all of us.
Thank you, Jimmy. Real pleasure and honor to be part of this amazing thing that you put together. I think the vision that you are bringing to this global forum industry is unprecedented. And I truly believe that, you know, businesses of the future are probably going to come out of collaborations that we would make on the DLC platform. Very excited to be partnering with you and being part of this committee. So all the best to you and kudos to everything that you do.
Thank you, Chetan. Chetan, it's amazing. People like you with the kind of experience, 250 outlets is not small, and that's the kind of experience we need to share with the rest of the people. What is the secret behind it? What are the learnings? What are the best practices? And how can people who are looking at scalability within their hospitality businesses to roll out, what can they learn from somebody like you? So DLC is all about bringing such talent together. Thank you. Thank you, Chetan. We have yet another youngster over here who's a great, great talented chef, Jaybir Kohli. A director of Pritham Group, awarded CIVC Excellence from the French government. and a very, very passionate hotelier. Jaybir, warm welcome from all of us. Here it is, youngsters like you that keep me kind of going all hammer and tong, because understanding and learning and keeping close connects with you will ensure that there is a continuity in business and we never disrupt or we never kind of derail. Over to you.
So I remember the initial discussion that we had about DLC at my house. We were having dinner and you took me to the side and you were like, you know, we're doing a business platform, and you kind of explained the concept to me. And it was really exciting to know that this is a platform, not just for learning, but also for kind of connecting with people as well as lifestyle. And I think I'm most looking forward to the forums and your 25 pieces of content a month, because it's just a fun way to keep learning and just keep yourself updated with what's happening in the world. And instead of, you know, kind of just going through.
Thank you, JB. Lovely speaking to you. Good luck. I'm sure some of you have some questions. I would be more than happy to take them on and answer as crisp as I can. We have the first question from Kush Kapoor.
No, first of all, thank you. I mean, it's a pleasure to be on this platform. I'm just keen, and I guess you've already answered. I was very curious to know, when do we have this first meetings? Maybe the physical meetings happening in our own cities, actually.
Kush, we'll be launching chapter cities. Today, we've launched them online. But as soon as the numbers are allowed, we need about 400 to 500 people, even in New York or in London or in Mumbai. In smaller cities, it'll be a little smaller crowd. But as soon as it is allowed post-pandemic, we will be doing in the physical launches. We call these, the physical meets are known as U-turn events. U-turn events are amazingly planned. Every chapter city meets 3 times a year. And these are predetermined dates. They are not flimsy and flexible based on whims and fancies. So everybody can plan their schedules. Each U-turn event has a combination of 5 committees giving content. So it doesn't repeat for a whole year. Each time you go, there is something different you learn. It doesn't repeat. The same topics and the subjects do not repeat for the next whole year. It's followed by a curated lifestyle exhibition, which is going to be of luxury lifestyle products only for the members of DLC. And then it is topped up by our Wine, Spirits, Cigars committee, our Chefs committee, our Events and Entertainment committee to curate an evening that's unforgettable. It's all about passion. It's not about the money. 100% of revenue generated goes back to the city. It doesn't go to DLC. So any sponsorships, anything that we do within the exhibition space and generate revenue is put back into the U-turn event. So if in a particular U-turn event we've been able to serve a Chandon, the next event we go in for a Moe Chandon, and if we still make more money, the member should go in for a Crystal or donate to charity of their choice. So the whole idea within DLC I've kept is all the entertainment. It's about appreciating good things in life, not just throwing money. These events are going to be worthy of spending family time. I always ask myself when I'm invited somewhere, if it's not for business and work, whether it's worthy of my family time, or would I be more happy just dining with my family somewhere outside? If it is worthy of my family time, there are no avenues. Kush, honestly speaking, there are hardly very, very few avenues where you go with your entire family and it's going to be worthy of spending that entire evening. I know some of the other organizations where people go and just put their attendance because they need that attendance for their some rating system or marks. I don't want any of those frivolous things happening within DLC. If people are going to attend it, people should love it. They should find worthy of their time. They should fix up the next date in their calendars and make sure that they're there. So this is how the physical event and interactions would be. Apart from that, we have an IP of workshops. Every committee of 26 committees has going to be mandated to do a workshop a month. Now, these workshops within the city will be in person, but globally people can take advantage of it. So it's going to be a digital world as far as workshops are concerned. Over and above this, there is a global summit, 19 global summits between 26 committees. In Lonavala Della Resorts, we are building the global summit headquarters to host events, venues, conferencing facilities and studios. You just saw a glimpse of the studios we established in Mumbai. It's double the size of studio that's coming up. 600 pieces of content to generate, 300 meetings a year between 54 committees, communities for social impact, 26 committees. All of this put together makes it into almost 300 events. It's practically an event a day. The only way you can deliver quality events is if you do this entire thing in-house with the finest of technology, finest of people who are full-time employed and delivering quality time and results. So thank you. I hope I've been able to answer you.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Hey, how are you? Nice to see you, Jimmy. Jimmy, one of the things that, as you know, I literally promote and orchestrate sustainable lifestyle in terms of the earth as well as people. And in our industry, especially at least in America, one thing that we encounter the most is mental health and addiction in our industry. And that is something that I've seen that you've not brought up as at least right now. And I really truly think that I think this is something that echoes even something that I think Alan Coxon could maybe endorse too and say, yes, addiction is a big issue. Mental health is a big issue. And I think that creating that type of sustainability and a sustainable lifestyle, not just for Earth in terms of materials, but also on Earth because of humans who live here, is I think something that we really, really truly need to address. And I sincerely hope you could put a little more attention on hospitality in these two sectors.
Sure. Chef, let me first compliment you. I love what you do. I really admire what you do. Very few people within the world of hospitality would be taking up sustainability so seriously the way you do it and demonstrated via your skills and your work. It's incredible. Everybody should follow and see what you do. It's amazing. Within the social impact, it'll hold a very special place, and I'm going to post this event, speak to you in person and see how we can start putting our plans into action and roll out. Speaking of mental health and addiction, we have a health and wellness committee. We just launched it, I think about 3 weeks back or something around there. I've been doing so many launches, I've lost track, but we've launched our health and wellness committee. Amazing committee led by a fantastic young guy from Singapore, Kenzo. He's a genius and a passionate man. Within the committee, mental health plays a very, very important role. Addiction we've dealt with in a different manner, but mental health overall post-pandemic is a serious area of concern and challenge. I'm not talking of per se addiction, but purely mental health. Post-pandemic, people were already stressed, and post-pandemic mental health has gone to a 10x number of people desperately requiring it. Some of them do not even know they require counseling. They need support. So we are working very strongly on delivering as much content as we can. Thank you, Chef. Well, it's an hour, 17 minutes. It's been an absolute pleasure to speak to all of you, getting to know each one of you. Some of you, your ideas, suggestions are most welcome. Everything, all good things come to an end before they begin again. And I have absolutely enjoyed speaking to all of you. I hope you've done the same today. Cool is going to be one point of contact for the committee and coordinating with each and every one of you from content to physical events to workshops. Thank you. Love you all. Stay safe. Bye.